Break Nation! We are back.
We've seen no deer. We have a little lesson for you folks. We're going to learn a new word today. It's called marsupial. Do you know what marsupial means? Marsupial means a wet, warm sensation in your under britches. Wet britches. Wet britches.
If you have to go in from hunting and dry your undershorts. Marsupial.
Marsupial. Can I get the land of origin, please?
Can I get the language of origin for marsupial, please? Can you use marsupial in a sentence, please?
When you're sitting in the tree stand and everything around you is wet, including your undershorts, marsupial.
Marsupial. We came to the back of our property. We're under a pine tree that's raining water all over us. The seats are wet. Our britches are marsupial.
It's December 14th. We are up in New York. It is the third last day of muzzle musket season. We got the smoke poles on hand. Show them your smoke pole.
Hey, you want to see this thing? It's not bad. It's a nice little... Look at that.
It's a nice little musket. It's a nice little unit. Can you shoot that thing? We got a double musket barrel going on up here, and we are saddled up, but we have not seen a deer yet. I apologize. We're going to get away from today. We're going to go back to the first week in November, the second part of our New York rut hunt. Who we got on the film?
Oh, well, we got a little bit of Dave, myself, Uncle Jay, Dad, but more importantly, Uncle Jimmy comes up here.
The man of the hour.
And just smokes the biggest buck that's probably ever come off this property. Daggers. So if you thought the first part of our rut week was good, rut on last week's episode. We'll get ready for us to rock your skivvies for round two, the second half of the rut week here. We're going to bring it to you.
Daggers coming at you.
Coming right in hot.
Day four of rut week. Dean and I got out around lunchtime, and we knew we had some rain coming in for the rest of the week, and our goal was just to be in the woods. It was November 6th. So we went in lunchtime, and we set up a couple blinds to prepare for the rest of the week. Dean and my dad were set up in this apple orchard, and Uncle Jay and I were sitting on the frigid forage. We brought our buddy Harry, the decoy, in with us. It seemed like the decoy was working, so with rain in the forecast for the next day or so, we were going to stick it out. We really had a lot of confidence that Harry was going to lure in one of our shooter bucks that we could get a shot at. Morning started off kind of slow, and around 9:30 we all got a text from Uncle Jimmy that says, "I just shot a nice 8-point. I think the hit was good."
So my dad and I were sitting about 200 yards down the ridge from Uncle Jimmy up, and his text actually said, "I just shot a nice 8-point." So, you know, we're going back and forth in the tree like, which one could it be? We got a few 8-points on trail camera.
See if we can find this deer. He hasn't looked yet, but he got a full pass through, blood all over the arrow, so it sounds like it's a good hit.
We hadn't seen a deer that morning, literally nothing. So we gave it an hour, hour and a half. We were like, "Uncle Jimmy, we're coming up. We're coming to help you track this deer." So we slipped down. We got up there, you know, he showed us his arrow where he hit. Immediately when I saw the arrow, I was like, this deer's done. We go about 60 yards and there's literally a cliff drop off down in this ravine. And we get to the top of it and my dad spots his buck down in the creek. And as soon as I got over the hill and saw the deer, all I saw was his beam sticking up and my jaw just dropped. I was like, oh my God, that's Daggers.
Oops. Those Daggers.
Shit,
he just killed the best buck on the freaking property.
That's a beautiful buck, guys.
Dude, you have no idea.
I don't know.
You have
no idea what buck. I don't know how bad I wanted you guys to shoot that freaking deer. I feel like you guys needed that on your cameras.
Oh, he's dead now.
That Holy is my shit. Best buck ever. Oh man. I can't freaking believe it. There ain't no way this deer stuck around without that doe being around. He had me pegged. He couldn't make me out. I wouldn't move. I wouldn't look at him. He was pegged. He was no way I got this deer without that doe. Are you filming this?
Yeah. By this time it was lunchtime. Dave and Uncle Jay got out of their blind for an hour or so, came back to camp. We had to set the deer up, do a little photo shoot. I mean, we were still trying to soak this all in and figure out what the heck just happened.
And there it is.
We spent the rest of the week in the woods. I mean, we were sitting daylight to dark, packing sandwiches in the woods. We probably had 70 to 80 hours on stand.
He's cutting daggers!
That's dagger! You know what's good about this loin? You can taste the brascus in it.
New dagger, fresh.
I can taste
the brascus. Getting our dang money back with this one.
Look at that smoking, searing, filet mignon.
I will.
It's good.
You ever seen a loin before that looks like that?
It's a five-year-old loin.
It's a five-year-old loin right there.
What happened? Daggers is too strong for the plastic floor.
Use that. Some tough meat.
You're still using it.
Oh, that's the butt end.
No, you get the whole thing. Oh, the butt end.
Butt me up.
Reload!
Surprisingly, I haven't broken a pork yet.
Yeah, you broke 9 yesterday.
Nine.
Took care of that.
I'm still using the same one that I used yesterday. I just washed it.
Next year, maybe? Next year, maybe?
A big one.
Tomorrow?
Another one just comes right in. How long does it take?
10 minutes.
15 minutes. I mean, really.
As soon as you rattle.
If you're a bow hunter, there's 1 week out of the whole year that you want to be in a tree, and it's right now.
Yeah.
It's right now. You couldn't have went out and bought a better meal than this.
No.
No way.
Don't live the beast.
Daggers is no match for the cabin cutlet. Oh man, that was good.
Wow,
I needed that.
Tough.
I needed that.
You guys don't mind if I use my fingers, do you? I didn't think so.
And you have too much pasta, you have to use it.
You got a secret pasta, you have to use it.
To end our rut week, you know, with the guys that we all grew up, Dean and I, all, you know, these guys brought us up hunting. We aren't here today without them. And to be in camp with them, celebrating, feasting on the beast to end out the week, what more could you ask for?
Ask for any more than that.
It was awesome. It was awesome.
I mean, we live and talk about those nights and those memories. That's what lives, you know, in our minds. That's just what sits, it's what sinks in. And we look back on all these years and, you know, David, that huge buck you killed at 8 point, just those nights we had
after that
kill together. It's just, that's where all the fun is. That's what tag and bragging, that's what this sport is all about, with family and friends. And it's just, it doesn't get any better. We hope you enjoyed this week's episode of TNB TV. Stick around with us next week. Dave and I are heading back home to Ohio. We're actually going to split up, and we're getting down and dirty right in the middle of some serious rut action. So stick with us, because it does get a little bit wild. Stay tuned. More TNB TV.
Thanks for watching, baby.
Hot. We love you.
Spicy and hot.
We love you.
That's what we do.
Over and out. Oops.
Me and you, Fat Joe, let's dance.